Hi students, good morning. How are you all? I hope you are good. All of you welcome to the online classes. Today our topic is climate of India. This is a fourth chapter in social studies. In this lesson we learn about climate of India, climate and weather, climographs of a few places in India, factors influencing climate and weather. Next, global warming and climate changes, AGW and climate change, impact of climate change on India. These topics are we learn in this class. First of all, you learn about climate and weather. Climate refers to the sum of weather conditions and variation over a large area for a long period, that is 30 years. This is called climate. Climate refers to such conditions over a large area and follows a similar general pattern over many years. What have been the general conditions year after year over 30 years or more gives us the climate. There are variations from year to year, but a basic pattern remains the same. Here, weather means state of the atmospheric pressure over an area at any point of time. This is the difference between climate and weather. Weather can be changed in minutes, hours. It may rain, it may hot. Elements in the climate or weather. Some elements are in the lesson. Temperature, wind, atmosphere pressure, humidity, precipitation. These are included in weather. These are present in the climate. Without these elements, there is no climate, there is no weather. Elements in the climate or weather can be shown on the graphs. These are called climographs or climatographs. Climographs show average monthly value of maximum temperature, minimum temperature, and rainfall for a given place. Next, climographs of a few places in India. The climographs below show that temperature and rainfall vary in different parts of the country. Students, we see the some climographs. New Delhi, Leh, Jaipur and Chennai. Students, all of you observe carefully these climographs. First of all, we see the New Delhi climograph. New Delhi, it is the capital of India. Here, in this climograph, in the x-axis, we see the months from January to December. Y-axis indicates rainfall in millimeters. Left side, we see the rainfall. Right side, we see the temperature in Celsius. Here, red color shows maximum temperature, blue color shows minimum temperature, blue color bars shows rainfall. Here, in this Delhi, we know the what is the highest temperature in Delhi, what is the lowest temperature of Delhi. Which months get highest rainfall, which months gets lowest rainfall. These things are you learn in this class. Here, all of you look at the carefully climatograph of India. Here, temperature and rainfalls given in this climatograph. Here, Delhi has a continental type of climate or extreme climate, because Delhi far away from the sea, that's why we say the we called the continental type of climate. Delhi has continental type of climate. We see the rainfall in the left in millimeters. In Delhi, maximum highest temperature 40 degrees Celsius recorded. In Delhi, minimum lowest temperature 8 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius temperature recorded. Here, which months have highest temperature in Delhi? May, June months have highest temperature in Delhi. Which months have lowest temperature? December, January months have lowest temperature in Delhi climatograph. In Delhi, which months have high rainfall? Here, July, August months have 220 millimeter rainfall. Which months have low rainfall in Delhi? November, March months have 3 millimeters rainfall in Delhi. This is the information about New Delhi. Students, we see the Leh climatograph. Leh is capital of Ladakh. Ladakh is a union territory of India. Here, x-axis indicates months from January to December. Y-axis indicates rainfall in millimeters in left side. In the right side, temperature in Celsius. Here, we see the what is the maximum temperature, what is the minimum temperature, what is the highest rainfall, what is the lowest rainfall in this climatograph. Students, here Leh located in Himalayan range or cold desert area. Here maximum temperature is 26 degrees Celsius to 3 degrees Celsius. Minimum temperature record minus 13 degrees Celsius to 8 degrees Celsius. Here, July, August months have 15 millimeters rainfall. Minimum rainfall recorded 7 millimeters in October, 3 millimeters in November. Here, these blue boxes or blue bars indicate rainfall. What is the highest rainfall? What is the highest rainfall in Leh? Which months got highest rainfall in Leh? Here, July, August months have highest rainfall. That is 15 mm rainfall. Which months have lowest rainfall? Here, October months has 7 millimeters rainfall. And November has 3 millimeters rainfall. This is minimum rainfall in Leh. Students, now we observe the Jaipur climatograph. Jaipur is capital of Rajasthan. Jaipur located in desert area. Here also, x-axis indicates months from January to December. Y-axis indicate in the left side rainfall millimeters. Y-axis indicates in the right side temperature degrees in Celsius. Students, all of you look at the climatograph carefully. Here, red color shows maximum temperature. Students, in Jaipur, 41 degrees Celsius to 22 degrees Celsius maximum temperature recorded in Jaipur. 7 degrees Celsius to 26 degrees Celsius minimum temperature recorded in Jaipur. July, August months have highest rainfall. November and December months have lowest rainfall, that is 5 mm. Next, we see the Chennai climatograph. Here, x-axis indicates months from January to December. Y axis indicates rainfall. Here students, all of you look at the climatograph of Chennai carefully. Chennai located in coastal area. Maximum temperature is 38 degrees to 28 degrees Celsius. Minimum temperature 20 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius recorded. November has more rainfall, that is 350 millimeters. February has low rainfall, that is 2 mm rainfall. Chennai has highest rainfall because of retreating monsoons. That's why Chennai gets highest rainfall. Here some questions are given in these textbooks. Here, why is Shimla cooler than during summer? Answer is, Shimla is capital of Himachal Pradesh. Shimla and Delhi located at different latitudes. But Shimla is located in the mountain region. Mountain region generally, hilly region are cooler than other regions. That's why Shimla is cooler than during summer. Jaipur is hotter than Leh. Explain your reason. This is question. Jaipur is located in Thar Desert. Generally, the Thar Desert region temperature is very high. Leh is in the Himalayan mountain region in Jammu, Kashmir. That's why Leh is cooler than Jaipur. Next question is, explain the differences in temperature Jammu, Jaipur and Chennai. Here, Jaipur is located in Thar Desert area. Chennai is located in east coastal of Bay of Bengal. That's why desert climate influences the climate of Jaipur. Winds from the sea influences the climate of Chennai. Next, one table is given, that is Jaipur, Leh, New Delhi, Chennai. These are places. Here, relief region. What is the relief region of Jaipur? What is the relief region of Leh? What is the relief region of New Delhi? What is the relief region of Chennai? These things are, you are write down on the boxes. Range of maximum temperature during the year. Range of minimum temperature during the year. Name the wettest month and the rainfall mm for that month. Name the driest month and the rainfall mm for that month. Here, Jaipur relief region is desert. Jaipur located in desert. Here, range of maximum temperature during the year is 41 degrees Celsius to 22 degrees Celsius. Range of minimum temperature during the year in Jaipur 7 degrees Celsius to 26 degrees Celsius. Name the wettest month and the rainfall for that month, July, August, 22 mm. Next, name the driest month and the rainfall mm for that month is November and December, 5 mm. Next, Leh. Leh relief region is a cold desert. Leh located in cold desert. Leh has 26 degrees Celsius to 3 degrees Celsius. Range of minimum temperature during the year is 13 degrees Celsius to 8 degrees Celsius. Name the wettest month and the rainfall mm for that month is July, August, that is 15 mm. Name the driest month and the rainfall for that month is October and November. October has 7 mm, November has 3 mm. Here, New Delhi located at continental relief region. Range of maximum temperature during the year is 40 degrees Celsius to 20 degrees Celsius. Range of minimum temperature during the year 8 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. Name the wettest month and the rainfall mm for that month is
August, that is 200 mm. Name the driest month and the rainfall mm for that month is November 3 mm, March 4 mm. Next, Chennai. Chennai relief region is coastal. Chennai located in coastal area. Range of maximum temperature during the year is 38 degrees Celsius to 28 degrees Celsius. Range of minimum temperature during the year, that is 20 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius. Name the wettest month and the rainfall for that month is November 350 mm. Name the driest month and the rainfall mm for that month is February 20 mm. Students, next we see the factors influencing climate and weather. It is observed that for some places, for example Chennai, there is not much difference in the temperature across months. Some places, for example Delhi, have wide differences in temperature across the months. India experiences wide variation in temperature. The northern portion is bounded by the Himalayas, whereas southern peninsula is surrounded by seas. Some places are far from the coast. They are inland. Some places are at high altitude, whereas others are on the plains. The factors that affect climate are called climatic controls. These include, first one is latitude, second one is land water relationship, third one is relief, fourth one is upper air circulation. Here, first one is latitude or distance from the equator. Here, the average temperatures for the year drop as you go further away from the equator. For this reason, we divided the regions on Earth as first one is tropical, as those close to the equator. Second one is polar, as those close to the poles. Third one is temperate, as those in between these two extremes, that is tropical, another one is polar. If we compare the climate of Indonesia and Japan, we can understand the differences. The reason for these differences is the differential heating of Earth that you have read in earlier classes. Intensity of temperature depends on the latitude. The temperature of the atmosphere at a particular place near the Earth's surface depends upon the insolation, heat from sun rays received at that location. This is more intense in the low latitudes than in the high latitudes. As you move away from the equator towards the poles, the average annual temperature decreases. In India, the southern part lies in the tropical belt closer to the equator. Therefore, this region has a higher average temperature than the northern part. This is one reason for the climate of Kanyakumari being entirely different from Bhopal or Delhi. India is situated roughly between 8 degrees and 37 degrees north latitudes, and the country is divided into almost two equal parts by the Tropic of Cancer. The part south of the Tropic of Cancer lies in the tropical zone. The part north of the Tropic of Cancer lies in the temperate zone. Students, here one picture is there. 4.1 indicates influence of latitude on climate. Here some tropics are given: 0 degree equator, next 23.5 degree north Tropic of Cancer, Arctic Circle 66.5 degree north Arctic Circle, and north pole 90 degrees north pole. In the down in the south Tropic of Capricorn 23 and a half degrees south Tropic of Capricorn. Here 66 and a half degrees south Antarctic Circle are given in this picture. Students, this picture indicates land water relationship. The amount of sunlight that is first absorbed and then radiated back or directly reflected depends on the nature of the surface. Darker areas such as heavily vegetated regions tend to be good absorbers. Lighter areas such as snow and ice covered regions tend to be good reflectors. The ocean absorbs and loses heat more slowly than land. This affects climate in many ways. One of these is the formation of land and sea bridges. Using figure 4.2 explain how this happens. Recall from class 9th the connection between pressure and direction of wind. A large part of southern India, because of its long coastline, comes under the moderating influence of the sea. As such, the difference between the temperature of day and night and that of summer and winter is not much. This is known as equable climate. If we compare similar places on the same latitude and altitude, we can appreciate the effect of the sea. Relief. You have learnt that temperature decreases at the rate of 6.4 degrees Celsius for every 1000 meters height. Increase in altitude, hence hills and mountains will have lower temperature than location on the plain. Therefore, relief or altitude of a region influences the climate of the area. You would have heard about several hill stations of the Himalayan regions like Shimla, Gulmarg, Nainital and Darjeeling as places that have a cool climate even during the peak summer months. Similarly, Kodaikanal and Udagamandalam or Ooty have cooler climate compared to places near the coast. Upper atmospheric circulation. In the northern hemisphere, subtropical high pressure belt gives rise to permanent winds. They blow towards the equatorial low pressure belt by reflecting towards the west and are called trade winds. The German word trade means track and stands for blowing steadily in the same direction and in a constant course. India lies in the belt of dry northeast trade winds. The climate of India is also affected by the movement of upper air currents known as jet streams. These are fast flowing air currents in a narrow belt in the upper atmosphere. Above 12,000 meters, the speed varies from about 110 kilometers in summer to about 184 kilometers in winter. An easterly jet stream developed at about 25 degrees north. A jet stream causes the neighboring atmosphere to cool. This cooling effect of the easterly jet streams causes rain from clouds already found over this latitude, that is 25 degrees north latitude. Next, seasons. Winter. We discuss about winter season. The temperature in the India landmass considerably reduce from mid-November and this cold season continues till February. January is usually the coldest month. Day temperature sometimes drops below 10 degrees Celsius in several parts of the country. However, the cold weather is more pronounced in northern India. South India, especially the coastal areas enjoy a moderate climate as temperature remains well above 20 degrees Celsius. The lines in map 1 indicates below indicate places that have the same average temperature for January month. During winter, the weather is generally pleasant with clear sky, low humidity and cool breeze. Cyclone depressions coming from modern Mediterranean Sea called Western Disturbances cause low to moderate rainfall over North India. This rainfall is boon to wheat crop, which is generally cultivated in Rabi season. India lies in the trade wind belt of Northern Hemisphere. Northeast trades blow over India from land to sea and are therefore dry. However, some amount of rainfall occurs on the Coromandel coast of Tamil Nadu from these winds as they pick up moisture from the Bay of Bengal while crossing it. Students, here map 1 indicates India average temperature degrees Celsius in January. Here, all of you look at the India map carefully. Here, 10 degrees Celsius in Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Meghalaya and Arunachal Pradesh. These states have 10 degrees Celsius temperature. Next, 15 degrees red line indicates India average temperature. 15 degrees temperature in Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Sikkim, Meghalaya and Arunachal Pradesh. These states have 15 degrees Celsius temperature. Next, 20 degrees Celsius temperatures some states. 20 degrees Celsius temperature in Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and West Bengal. Next, 20 degrees temperature in Chhattisgarh. 25 degrees temperature in Maharashtra, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. 20 degrees temperature in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Here in the eastern states, 15 degrees temperature Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland. These states have 15 degrees Celsius in India map. Let us see the summer season. During the hot season, as we move from southern to northern part of the country, the average temperature increases starting in April. The temperature rises and slowly the maximum day. Here, the maximum day temperature exceeds 37 degrees Celsius in northern plains of India. By midday, day temperature may touch 41 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius in many parts of the country, especially in the northwest plains and central India. Even minimum temperature does not go below 20 degrees Celsius. The northern plains experiences dry and hot winds called Loo. These are Loo winds. Loo winds are dry and hot winds. Towards the end of the summer season, pre-monsoon showers, bursting monsoon are common in the Deccan Plateau. These help in the early ripening of mangoes and other plantation crops in peninsular India. Hence, they are locally known as mango showers in Andhra Pradesh. Next, we see the advancing monsoon. The climate of India is strongly influenced by the monsoon winds. The sailors who came to India during olden days noticed that regular periodic reversal of winds. They used these winds to sail towards the Indian coast. Arab traders named this seasonal reversal of wind system monsoon. The monsoon forms in the tropical area approximately between 20 degrees north and 20 degrees south latitudes. The southeast monsoon winds from the southern hemisphere carry moisture as they flow over the Indian Ocean and towards the equatorial low pressure zones. After crossing the equator, these winds deflect towards the low pressure formed in the Indian subcontinent. The heating of land creates low pressure on the landmass of Indian subcontinent, especially over central India and the Gangetic Plain. Together with this, the Tibetan Plateau gets intensely heated and causes strongly vertical air currents and the formation of low pressure over the plateau at above 9 kilometers altitude. They then flow as the southwest monsoon. The Indian Peninsula divides them into two branches, the Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal branch. The Bay of Bengal branch strikes the Bengal coast and the southern face of the Shillong Plateau. Then it gets deflected and flows westwards along the Gangetic Valley. The Arabian Sea branch arrives at the west coast of India and moves northward. Both the branches reach India by the beginning of June, which is known as one set of monsoon. They gradually spread over the entire country in 4 to 5 weeks. The bulk of the annual rainfall in India is received from southwest monsoon. The amount of rainfall is very high along the west coast due to the western Ghats. And in northeast India due to the high peaked hills. Tamil Nadu coast or Coromandel, however, remains mostly dry during this season as it is in the rain shadow area of the Arabian Sea branch and is parallel to the Bay of Bengal branch. Next, let us see the retreating monsoon. October, November is a period of transition from a hot wet conditions to dry winter conditions. The retreat of the monsoon is marked by clear skies and rise in temperature. The land is still moist. Owing the conditions of high temperature and humidity, the weather becomes rather oppressive. This is commonly known as October heat. The low pressure conditions which once prevailed over northwestern India move far south to the center of the Bay of Bengal by early November. During this period, cyclonic depressions are common which originate over the Andaman area. These tropical cyclones are often very destructive. The thickly populated deltas of the Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri are their targets. No year is ever found disaster free. Occasionally, these tropical cyclones visit Sundarbans and Bangladesh too. Bulk of the rainfall of the Coromandel coast is derived from depressions and cyclones. Students, here map 3 indicates India one set of southwest monsoon. Map 4 indicates India withdrawal of southwest monsoons. Next, In the Indian tradition, the year is divided into 6 monthly seasons. This cycle of seasons that the people in North and Central India follow is based on their practical experiences and age-old perception of weather phenomena. There is a slight variation in the timing of the seasons between Northern and Southern India. Here, this table indicates traditional Indian seasons. Here, seasons, months according to the Indian calendar, months according to the Western calendar. Here, seasons, Vasanta, Grishma, Varsha, Sarad, Hemanta, Sisira, seasons are there in this table. Vasanta season started from Chaitra, Vaishakha in March and April. Grishma season started from Jyeshta, Ashada in May and June months. Varsha season started from Shravana, Bhadrapada in July, August. Sharad season started from Aswija, Kartika in September and October. Hemanta season started from Margashira, Prusya in November and December. Shishira season started from Magha and Palguna in January and February. Here we see the global warming and climate change. As the earth started to take shape from a fireball to a planet, many gases were released. These gases did not escape into outer space because of the earth's gravitational pull. It still holds them back. The result, a thin layer of gases surrounds earth and provides us several important benefits. For example, the oxygen that we breathe, the ozone that protects us from harmful ultraviolet rays from the sun, the nitrogen that our planets use to make proteins that we need, the medium through which fresh water is circulated and keep us warm. Recently, scientists are discovering large volume of methane under the frozen tundras of the far northern latitudes, mainly in the vast expanses of northern Russia. As global temperature increases, the ice in the tundra melts more. The methane that is trapped under the ice escapes into the atmosphere, increasing the global temperatures. In turn, this causes even more ice to melt, releasing even more methane, and so on. Methane is said to be even more powerful than carbon dioxide as a greenhouse gas. AGW and climate change. AGW means anthropogenic global warming. Anthropogenic means caused by humans. AGW is causing many changes in the distribution of heat in the Earth system. Remember how atmospheric and oceanic circulations keep redistributing the heat in the world. AGW disturbs this system and the redistribution system. The disturbance itself is not so much of a problem. It is the rapidly with which it is happening. When the redistribution system is disturbed, weather and climate patterns change. Long-term changes, climatic changes happen from a accumulations of short-term changes, weather changes. Here, an international effort to form an agreement whereby all countries try to reduce their emission of greenhouse gases has so far not been achieved. an international organization called Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC. IPCC means an international organization called Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, was formed to address this issue. It has held many conferences to work out a treaty among the nations of the world to reduce AGW and try to slow down the process of climate change. None of these have been successful. The latest attempt was made at the IPCC conference in Warsaw in Poland in 2013. This has also failed to achieve any agreement. Broadly, the disagreements are between the developed countries, mainly industrialized, economically more advanced countries of the West, and developing countries, countries that are not as industrialized. Developed countries want developing countries to cut down on burning coal and other activities that add greenhouse gases to the atmosphere. Developing countries argue that developed countries precisely by burning fossil fuels in their development. Developing countries say that their economic development will be seriously damaged if they don't burn fossil fuels, mainly coal. And the developed countries should do their fair share of work to help find alternatives that can help the developing countries to progress. Impact of climate change on India. Though a rise of 2 degrees Celsius in average temperature may appear to be small, it would result in a rise of 1 meter in sea levels by early next century. This would affect large portions of our coastal areas, and millions of people would have to be shifted. They would lose their livelihood. Nearly 200 squatter families living in Nonadanga in East Kolkata for the past few years are in the process of being evicted by the Kolkata Metropolitan Development Authority. Here KMDA, it is very important for one mark question. KMDA means Kolkata Metropolitan Development Authority. Many of the families came to Kolkata in search of work after the Ayla super cyclone ravaged Sundarbans in 2009. The other effect would be on rainfall. This is likely to be more erratic and lead to greater imbalances. Some places are likely to receive excess rainfall, whereas others would get less than normal. Hence, droughts and floods are expected to increase. This would greatly affect the agriculture pattern and people's livelihood. The faster melting of Himalayan glaciers would disturb the livelihood of freshwater fisher folk, as their natural habitation of fish is affected. Similarly, freak weather conditions that you read about are likely to increase. Climate change is something that happens at a global level. Therefore, it affects all of us.